We had actually, our original chart was that it was going to be hitting Florida directly. Maybe I could just see that, Kevin. It was going to be hitting directly, and that would have affected a lot of other states. But that was the original chart, and you see it was going to hit not only Florida, but Georgia. It could have was going toward the Gulf. That was what was originally projected. And it took a right turn.
President, you showed us the map earlier, the initial forecast of it. It appeared to have been, I guess, edited or something to include Alabama. Can you explain how that change was made?
Did I know that Alabama was in the original forecast. They thought it would get it as a piece of it. It was supposed to go. Actually, we have a better map than that, which is going to be presented, where we had many lines going directly, many models, each line being a model. And they were going directly through. And in all cases, Alabama was hit, if not lightly, in some cases pretty hard. Georgia, Alabama was a different route. They actually gave that a 95% chance probability. It turned out that that was not what happened. It made the right turn up the coast. But Alabama was hit very hard and was going to be hit very hard along with Georgia. But under the current, they won't be. Georgia will be possibly. We're going to see. We're right at that point right now. But I think Georgia's going to be in great shape. Everyone's going to be in great shape because we're going to take care of it regardless. But the original path was through Florida. That was probably 3 days. I think that's probably 3-4 days old. The original path that most people thought it was going to be taking, as you know, was right through Florida, where on the right would have been Georgia, Alabama, et cetera.
And that map that you showed us today looked like it almost had like a Sharpie.
I don't know.
As the storm is barreling down on the United States, President Trump used an altered map of Hurricane Dorian's path while in the Oval Office today to show that Alabama might have been hit, as he had said and been mocked online for saying. CNN's White House correspondent Caitlin Collins joins me now. Caitlin, people are actually have now died from this storm, and President Trump is still focused on proving that his tweet was correct?
And remember, the president is in charge of overseeing the federal response to a storm like this, so that's why it's incredibly important what a president says in a time like this. And this all goes back to this briefing today in the Oval Office, this hurricane briefing the president was receiving, where he pulled out this dated map, a map that he received during a briefing last week that showed the projection of the storm of Hurricane Dorian. And it had this little thing called the cone of uncertainty on it. That's where the potential of the storm could go, but the experts aren't exactly sure because, of course, like this one did, it turned. But of course, today it had a little addition to it, this black Sharpie line that had been drawn on top of that projection cone, showing that Alabama could potentially be in the path of Hurricane Dorian, even though experts had said that was not the case. This comes after President Trump tweeted on Saturday that Alabama could be impacted by the storm, could be hit by the storm, something he insisted later on at the FEMA headquarters, even though the National Weather Service in Birmingham, Alabama, came out in a tweet and said Alabama was not going to be impacted in any way by Hurricane Dorian. Still, since those tweets came out, since the president was criticized for saying that they could be impacted when they were likely not to be, according to the experts, the president has insisted, yes, Alabama was in the projected path of this storm, as he did today with this doctored map, which, of course, there are questions now about who it is that altered it. The president said today he doesn't know. We know he's famous for using Sharpies to write letters to people. DHS is saying they did not provide the president with this altered map. And NOAA, which handles a lot of this, said they don't know, and they're referring us back to the White House on this.
Okay. I mean, people are dead from the storm, and others might also be killed. And he's focused on proving something that he said that was apparently wrong is actually right. I mean, that's bizarre.